Thank you, Dr. Martin. Now I call for Professor Hisham Mustafa. He's a professor of vascular surgery in Qasr Al-Aini. He will give a talk about re-entry for long total SFA occlusion devices versus simple novel technique.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وكأنه حوار قصير بين لسان الحال ونسائم الرحمات، رفعت كفي للإله رجوته، والروح من بين الحنايا مثقلة. أخبرته أني حملت من الأسى ما لا تطيق مدامعي أن تحمله، فصرت بروحي راحة وسكينة، وقالت لي أن البشائر مقبلة، واليسر آت والهموم ستنجلي، والعسر فينا ليس إلا مرحلة. I think all of us are very familiar with such angio, which shows long CTO of the superficial femoral artery. And we do agree all that the most durable solution when indicated is femoropopliteal bypass, provided that we have a good takeoff, good conduit, and good runoff. However, still the endovascular solution is very appealing, being minimally invasive procedure. If we go to the definition of long CTO, we say that it is more than 20 centimeters, more than 3 months, and lesion inducing more than 99% occlusion. For any subject, if we are going to study, we want to know pathology and management. The pathology of CTO is nothing but plaque and organized thrombus. The organized thrombus, we have a proximal cap, body, and distal cap. Regarding the rationale of management of CTO, we have 2 points. The first is to cross the lesion, and the second is to treat it by whatever method, either balloon angioplasty or stenting or whatever. We go to the crossing. If we want to cross CTO, we have barriers. These barriers are either failure or complications. Failure to engage into the lesion, to pass through the lesion, to come back to the true lumen. And the complications which are encountered, either branch occlusion, proximal or distal, or perforation. We are going to focus on failure, but please, if you are going to tackle CTO by endovascular mean, please don't burn the open solution. Failure of crossing. What are the predictors and how to combat this failure? We can summarize failure of crossing angiographically into angulation of the target vessel, blunt cab or bridging collaterals that take the wire away from the lesion, calcification at the entry point or at the distal cab, small diameter vessel, and extent and multiplicity of the lesions. The point is how to combat failure. The methods to combat failure are tools, techniques, and devices. By tools, I mean wires and catheters. By techniques, it should be preceded by strategies. And at the end, we have devices. But please don't forget that we are a vascular surgeon. We can go back to the open solution. Concerning the wires, we have criteria in the wire which are dedicated for CTO, criteria in the tip, and criteria in the shaft. And these are examples for the wires used for CTO. And for the catheters, we have certain features in the catheters and function of the catheters that can support or give feedback or allow wire exchange. And this is an example for a catheter that is used with a wire to cross CTO. The second after tools is the techniques and the strategies. We have two strategies. Either we are going anti-grid or retrograde. If we go anti-grid, we have two options, either go with one wire or two wires. If we go to retrograde, definitely we need two wires. The anti-grid approach, we have either using the same wire all through, or we use a wire at a stage and replace it with another wire at another stage and so on. If we are going to use the same wire, the wire manipulation are either wire navigation to reach to the lesion and wire negotiation to cross the lesion by multiple techniques, sliding, drilling, and penetration. And the difference between drilling and penetration is that drilling is a continuous torque in a clockwise or anti-clockwise, but in the same direction, while penetration, you are alternating between clockwise and anti-clockwise during the same procedure. Another method of using a single wire at a time, and then you do escalation of the wire. You go to a wire with a higher characteristic, start by floppy, then intermediate, then more stiff wire. This is one method for anti-grade strategy. The other method for anti-grade strategy is to use double wire technique. The first wire is a wire that is going to park into a collateral or into a false channel, and the second wire is the wire that is going to do the job. This is an example for the wire that park into the collateral, and this is an example for a wire that is going to park into the false lumen, and the second wire will do the job to cross the lesion. These are examples of two wire technique, which is subintimal tracking and reentry, where we go by the first wire all through the lesion in the subintimal plane. When we reach the site of reconstitution of the true lumen, we stop by this wire and go by a stiff wire to enter into the true lumen. And another technique, which is limited anti-grade subintimal tracking. And another one for the same strategy is what is called CISO wiring. The other method or the other strategy is to go by double wire technique, retrograde. This is actually is not true retrograde. It's again, it is anti-grade. The retrograde wire is just mark the site of the distal cap or act as a target for the anti-grade wire. If we go to true retrograde technique, we have either cart or reverse cart or the double balloons. And we go to the last technique is using devices. Actually, we have many devices, devices for guiding and debulking.
Time out.
And devices for crossing and re-entry. These are devices for crossing and re-entry, you know them all. And lastly, we will go back to the open technique if we fail to cross by endovascular methods. This is a novel combination where we do eversion end arterectomy at the site of the distal part of the lesion, and then we have an end arterectomized segment about 1 centimeter. Then we will go to re-anastomose the artery end to end again. Now the flow will go from the proximal true lumen to the subintimal lumen along the lesion. Then in the end arterectomized segment distally, and again back to the true lumen. What are the value of this technique? You don't need to abort. You don't need to use expensive re-entry devices. You don't need for sophistication. You do limit the long false lumen because you just stop at the distal part of the false lumen, and re-entry is no more a point or a line, it is a segment which is in the arthrectomized segment, and you don't need for two vascular approaches exposures if you are going to do femoropopliteal bypass, and also we don't need for a conduit. Lastly, again, you are a vascular surgeon. Remember that you are not intervention radiologist. You can adopt this technique and can convert failure to success. I'm sorry for delay, and thank you for your listening. Thank you also for the organizing.